right up, step right up. Beyond the threshold of this theme song lies the greatest show you've ever heard. A podcast where the topic is everything our fine specimens can think of. That's right, sit on down and have yourselves to listen to Groupcast. At center stage is Casey, creator of the show and part-time llama enthusiast.
Women are a lot like teddy bears, because people are often surprised when they hear I've been having sex with one.
On a soapbox, somewhere in the hedge maze, is Lennon, the comedian with a heart rate of video games.
People say that my dick is like the Loch Ness Monster. Not a whole lot of people seen it, and very many people doubt its existence.
Getting a donut in the break room is Rolls, a man who can lift two beer cans at once and not spill them. Sometimes.
Toad the Wet Sprocket, and other 90s band names.
Now, without further ado, let the show begin!
Alright.
Alright. We got bad jokes and that.
I don't even know if bad is the right word for what those jokes were.
They were something.
I've been hoping to fit that in somewhere, though.
They weren't quite jokes. They were more of joke.
That's what he said.
There you go. Speaking of bad jokes, mm-hmm. We'll just follow it up right with it.
Bad jokes is a category in the greatest bits that are coming up in 5 episodes.
Is it really?
Yep.
Ooh.
Well, we had it last time, too.
Is it? Oh, yeah, we did, didn't we? Is half the segment right now Fat Deb stuff?
One of them is, yes.
Oh, just one? Wow.
Well, usually I like to find ones that have context beforehand.
Okay, that makes sense, yeah.
Yeah.
You could just play that whole episode if you want the context.
I love how I titled that one, Completely Tasteful Fat Jokes.
Oh, yeah, and tasteful they were.
Yeah.
She's polymorphous. She sounds amorphous. That was one of my jokes rolls. I don't know if you picked up on that. Yeah, we need to fail. We need the prices right. Horn on soundboard. Where's Bald Brian when you need him?
Where is our soundboard in general?
She canceled.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah. Erica couldn't be here this episode.
For good reason.
Yeah, for excellent reason. But at the same time, what Roll said, it wasn't a thing that takes all weekend. That
it's true. But still, whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, we were going to be at her place at noon. Probably done by 1:32, out by 2.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, that's the whole thing right
we
there.
Have all Sunday.
All Sunday.
But we have
Sunday, Sunday, Sunday.
And especially if, and I can't say for sure the art program at SHIP.
But yeah.
And mine, that's actually where I got my resume from.
Yeah.
Was from the senior seminar. Like, we had to
create
same
one. Here.
So it's like, I just took that and I literally took 10 minutes and updated and put in the new job that I had and all these other things, and here you go.
It was a massive focus in the art department as well.
I think I'm going to try to apply, because another friend of mine...
You're going
to
be a teacher.
Dave. No. Oh. I'm going to try to apply for the Amazon
warehouse.
All right,
faggots, let me tell you
about...
teach you guys history.
You know,
we're going to be talking about Vikings, and we're going to be talking about Vikings. Any questions?
I actually did consider that as a long-term thing to try.
Anybody who brings me a beer gets a 5% bonus.
As in, like, a college professor as opposed to, you know.
Mm.
I couldn't teach anyone below high school, really, and be an accredited teacher.
Uh-huh.
It's funny, as I'm surrounded by people who are teachers in training and people who have been around teaching for a very long time.
Yes.
And it's split right down the middle. Some people like exclusively high school, and some people like anything that's not high school.
Yeah.
Well, it's they don't want to have to deal with the rough and tumble goth kids.
I think the issue is...
Well, I'm trying to get a hot topic.
What level of asshole children do you want to deal with? 16-year-olds? Or 8-year-olds.
Right. I think middle school's probably the sweet spot.
Both are gigantic.
That's what I've heard
dick balls.
Dick balls.
In completely different fashions.
They're fucking cooking bowls.
Yes.
Like the high school kid will interrupt your class, but you know, with just jokes or some or texting or something stupid
or
like
angst.
That. Yeah. As opposed to the 8-year-old who'll interrupt your class by walking over and starting to punch the other kid in the head. So you really have to... That's why it's like, okay, I get, you know, try to get my doctorate in sociology or something down the road or whatever. And it's like, okay, well, go to college. Because then I can just throw people out of the room.
Right, yeah. Or you could just...
That is a source of
or
power.
Or the people who suck in your class usually just leave of their own accord.
Yeah.
I've noticed that.
I think eight-year-olds do that.
I had the one art class...
Billy, you're failing math. You're out.
The one art class that I had, which was awful.
You take an econ class yet?
I have, actually. I got a C.
Those are the
it.
Ones that people...
I got a C in it.
Yeah.
That's where people disappear.
Yeah.
Well, in this art class, first of all, this woman treated everyone like they were kindergartners.
Oof.
Like, all right, class, everybody tell me what primary colors are. And she, like, stretches her arms out like she's going to give the entire
like
class a giant hug.
Yeah.
Primary colors!
Ugh.
And, people would just leave in the middle of that class. Not just...
I would leave in the middle of that
They would periodically show up. They wouldn't just drop the class. They would show up. And then halfway through the class, every time would be like, well, this is bullshit, and just leave.
Yeah.
And the classroom that we had it in, that door was like the loudest freaking door ever. So it would just go,
it was like, it's like the sound of her failure every time she heard it.
And every time somebody left, she would look at that door and just have this anguished look on her face like,
I lost another
one. Why would they do that?
Lost another one.
I don't understand.
That's why. The only art class I took was art appreciation.
There you go. This was art
that,
history,
I kinda,
and it was gross.
I kind of zoned out during the time. I forget who it was. It wasn't What's-His-Face. It was the other...
It was the other What's-His-Face.
It wasn't What's-His-Face. It was Who's a What's-It.
Short, bald professor.
Yeah, I know the short, bald professor. Yeah.
He was cool, but, I mean, I wasn't prepared for the class either, because it's, okay, here, I took it over the summer. Okay, let's meet up, you know, it was like 3 times a week for 2 hours or however long it was.
Right.
But, okay, here, let's look at this painting. What other style, what other artist painted in this style? It's like, to me, they all kind of look not the same. Because that would be, you know, but it's like,
right. Okay,
here's one Dutch master versus the other. It's like, I don't fucking know. You're supposed to teach me this. Like,
all right, class for $100.
With a D.
It's like a game of Jeopardy.
Yeah. Worst kind of Jeopardy.
Yeah. See,
no, that's what the exam was. He literally had like a slide projector, and he would go through and be like, "All right, which one is that?" And it'd be like A, B, C, or D, and you pick like, "Oh, this is Renoir or somebody," you know. And it's like, let me write something, please. That's what I'm good at. I'm good at writing.
See, I'm sort of lucky with the degree I'm going after. I'll be able to teach either high school or middle school.
Ooh, right.
I can pick.
You. Good
so,
for you.
And I can just switch in between whenever I want, pretty much.
That's convenient.
So, if I am in a high school job and I'm like,
that falls.
Don't really like this. I could just go and apply for a middle school job.
There you go. Because
it counts 6th through 12th grade.
Well, in the category of job that I had just had last, the, you know, the kind of human services thing.
Yeah.
If you work for up to 10 years in that field, which I'd like to, they'll straight up pay for the rest of your school.
Wow, that's
the state government. They'll be like, "Hey, you serve your community a lot, so here, yeah, that's what it is.
That's what the letter says verbatim."
Yeah.
Hey,
so it's like,
hey, we've noticed you kind of help people out sometimes.
Yeah. And I've been able to put off student loans because it's like every year they're like, "Okay, do you have enough income to afford whatever fucking ridiculous amount they want a month?" Yeah. And it's like,
oh,
you say
like
no.
Oh, it's like $400.
And then they'll default it back another year. So it's like, if I just do that for 10 years, those suckers are going to pay for everything.
I recently just looked up the interest rate on student loans.
They are
absurd.
Are
you ready for this? 10.8%.
Oh, yeah.
It's an unsubsidized loan. They can't, it's, you know, it actually brought up a thing I wanted to talk about, a little bit of politics, but... It's like, I saw Bernie Sanders, I think, was the one who sent out a tweet, and he's like, the loan rate shouldn't be so high. And then there's econ professors saying, no, it should be high, because here's why. It's not, there's no seizable assets in a student loan.
Oh, yeah.
They're not going to,
they have
they
no,
can't come and take your education to the bank, you know?
They're right out of college, they don't have any assets.
Yeah.
We could take your fucking cot.
Their asset is on the line, pretty much.
You know that pull-out sofa that you completely live on? Yeah.
You know that that VW minibus that you live in sometimes?
Well, listen, If a college kid lives in a VW microbus, that thing is fucking decked out like a fucking suite.
Yeah, pretty much
it has working electricity. There's Christmas lights all around the top. They got an Xbox hookup in there. That is a sweet pad, that VW microbus.
It's better than most apartments.
Exactly. I might be way too loud, I don't know.
It's possible. Mm. You're also banging the table.
Not really, I'm just...
Yeah, now you're banging the table. This is great.
Knocked on wood.
We've been doing this for how long?
Listen, I'll bang the table for emphasis whenever I want.
Don't spill the Pepsi.
Pepsi's okay. Don't worry about the Pepsi.
So I want to say this right away because I can't hold it in any longer. I love Amber's mom because of how she watches movies.
Amber's mom. Okay, and how she watches movies.
Explain yourself.
She is like the best worst commentator of all time.
No shit.
Before you
get into it, does Amber do the same thing?
No.
That strikes me as unfortunate.
No.
And odd. I would imagine she would do the same thing.
No. She doesn't.
Okay.
Though it's very evident where the derpiness comes from.
No kidding. I've heard the stories.
Yeah.
The derp is strong.
Like how she often, Amber's mom will often fly through the house, flopping her arms all over the place, proclaiming she has no bones.
And how often does this happen?
Often.
That's all you need to know.
Disturbingly often.
I live there, I know.
Yes.
I know these things. But we watched Guardians of the Galaxy the other day.
Okay.
And I the green one again?
And I wrote down everything she said.
No shit.
And at the end of the movie, when she had gone to go get something, Amber was like, she was actually quieter than usual.
Well,
so I want to watch more movies with this amalgamation of people just to see what happens.
Or watching more movies.
So I'm going to read out some of the stuff she said.
Do we want to get the bad comments music ready for this one?
Yeah, sure. Let's do it.
All right, hit that shit.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And now a reading of Amber's mom's comments at Guardians of the Galaxy.
It's a lengthy title.
Are those guys the police or something? If you want, I can describe scenes when they happen.
No, I think we could probably put it together.
Okay, yeah. Ew, why do they all have weird skin? What's this movie called? Defenders of the Galaxies?
That's it.
Her first reaction when seeing Thanos. He looks badass.
She's not wrong. I don't know what you expected.
Iron Man's not in this, right?
He could be. He was a Guardian of the Galaxy.
They all got killed? Are they making a shield? Tiny gasp, followed by, he can't touch it, because that means he's gonna die. I forgot about that. The scene where Rocket is, like, mourning over Groot's death, and Drax goes to sit next to him.
Yeah.
She says, now he's got a new friend and defender, Muscle Boob.
I imagine, based on the stories that I've heard, she has the memory and attention span of a hummingbird.
She is very derpy.
Yes. Clearly that is the case.
So,
nothing to add, huh? No.
You pretty much
that's
covered it for
as far as
me.
It went, huh?
Yeah.
It was so funny.
Speaking of that, I almost forgot about this. You see, the Vin Diesel is like, hey,
I'll play a witch hunter.
No, it was,
that is a real conversation that happened.
What's the fucking guy? I forget his name, since, of course, I'm on the podcast, and it's important to remember. From The Inhumans,
The Inhumans?
Yeah.
Black Bolt?
Yeah, thank you. Shit. Black Bolt. He's like, I don't know why he turned into Sylvester Stallone.
Well, listen,
They have to, hit me with some. Adrian!
I'll take Vin Diesel in any role where he's not allowed to speak. That's fantastic.
That's why I say the role of Groot was the most accurate and best role he could have had.
Uh-huh.
Well, I mean, he's still riding Paul Walker's corpse. through movies.
Is he like body surfing on it?
Yeah. No, I mean they're making they started a trilogy of more Fast and how many right. movies about car racing can you? And I love cars.
And why do they each have a different name?
And why are they all so furious all the time?
Yeah.
The next one's just going to be called The and The. Because they ran out of combinations
Fast
of words.
Fast and Furious. Fast and Furious.
Yeah.
Furious 7.
There was Fast 5 and Furious 7.
They'll start taking other movies and substituting in those words.
And then Fast
instead
and
of the
Furious.
Magnificent
the
Furious
7, of the Galaxy.
Instead of, like, the Magnificent 7 or, like, you know, the Dirty Dozen, it'll just be the Furious Dozen. The Fast 7. You know? Like, hey, what's going on here?
I'll tell you what doesn't go by fast, those fucking movies.
Yeah.
I liked Fast 5. I actually saw it in theaters because our good buddy Fred was like, we're going to see this fucking movie. And so he dragged me to go see it. Nice. We sat in the front row.
Oh, why?
Mm-hmm. Listen.
I almost did that before, but I was a kid.
Whoever wants to sit in the front row of a movie theater? You have your neck craned as far back as possible.
It's not like it's a live show.
Just to look the people on the screen
not
in the
eye.
Not
even like a band or something. It's not, like, there isn't anything going on with stage in front of you.
Nothing. Yeah. If anything...
There's no splash zone
it's
or
just
anything.
A wall of color.
Yeah. The perspective is so warped.
Yeah.
It's like you put something in Photoshop and set the Y value to 300%. The motherfucker stretched.
Yep. Because...
Back, middle, always.
At the,
yeah. Definitely in the middle
the
of
movie,
theater
the
moviegoer's
creed.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
So you don't have to deal with people making out.
You sit in the back room and let light come into your eyes, because that's how movies work.
Oh, speaking of movies.
Surround sound.
Speaking of movies. Casey, I don't know how much you'll care about this. Rolls, you might care about
this. I'll try
this.
To care.
November 7th, in this household, is a national holiday.
Yeah, I was actually going to ask if I could get a ride with that.
Exactly.
Come along for the show.
November 6th, I believe, because the 7th is a Saturday. So I believe November 6th is the release date for the new James Bond movie.
Ah, yes.
Which in this house is a national fucking holiday.
You better wear your fucking suits.
Hell yeah. I think my dad wore a tux to the movies once to see a James Bond
movie. Nice.
Yeah, he's weird. it's a little fucked up. So we're going to, at some point, I don't know when, meet up here. A bunch of people are going to meet up here. We're going to have breakfast of some kind. Hold on. I'm going to grab something from the fridge. Hold on. I'm going to talk loudly so many people still hear me.
I'm showing up.
I think it was for...
I'm coming.
Yeah, here it is. For Casino Royale, which was like 2007.
Yeah.
Oh, the jam!
Like the jam!
My dad went on eBay or something like that and bought this shit. Frank Cooper's Oxford. Vintage Oxford marmalade because James Bond would eat it for breakfast.
Let me take a picture
so
of that.
So we bought some, and this is what we were having for breakfast. Now, for those of you who can see right now, which is just two of you, I guess.
It's also in the links.
It's also practically full.
Yes.
Because this shit is garbage. So here it sits in the fridge for 7 years. Or
wow.
However fucking long. It's
8 years.
And it will sit forevermore.
Wow.
We had... My dad... Listen. The movie... For the movie.
Yeah.
Casino Royale. Casino. That's an important thing to keep in mind.
Okay.
I don't know if either of you guys have seen it. It's in like this back side room in my house over here. He brought home a motherfucking slot machine and set it up on the front fucking porch.
Yeah, I saw that.
That thing, also garbage. It was Chinese. You didn't understand a fucking thing that was going on it. It broke down constantly. It needed popped open to be reset. But we had a fucking, like, 20-person party, and then we all piled into, like, 5 cars and drove to the movie theater to watch this movie.
Wow.
And November 7th we're all doing it all over again.
Is he going to buy... are we all going to dress in, like, ghost costumes?
Ha-ha! Because it's Spectre.
With an I'll R-E and not E-R.
No, I'm going to bring the cat, though. I'm bringing my cat. I tried. Okay. And on November 7th, this...
we're going to eat it again.
Frank Cooper's Oxford. Vintage Oxford marmalade. Will sit right in that fridge where it fucking belongs.
I thought you were going to say, like, we're going to eat it again.
If you would like to eat the 8-year-old opened marmalade, you may eat the 8-year-old opened marmalade. I, however, will put on a fucking gas mask, sit in the back corner, and film you.
Yeah, it's too bad it's marmalade and not preserves. Then it would have been okay.
Right.
Because it's preserved.
I can't even imagine what the top layer of that shit looks like when it's open.
Probably like...
I'm putting it
probably
back.
Like pudding skins.
I'm putting it back in the fridge.
That would be my guess.
Yeah, I'm sure.
It's the skin of pudding.
So, I'm just throwing it out there to the two of you. You're invited to come to National James Bond Day at the Free Household.
I will remind you that I've never seen a James Bond movie all the way through.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I actually have the books, though. Of which I have never read.
Oh, really? Yeah. I've never read one of the books.
Hey, don't try to tell me the books are better than the movies.
For my... Because
you're wrong in this case.
For my 21st birthday, my cousins, who are huge hipsters, got me several books written by drunkards. And the card they gave me included recipes on how to make certain alcoholic beverages.
Oh,
like,
okay.
For James Bond, I got the recipe on how to make a dry martini.
Yeah.
And for Ernest Hemingway, I got something that had to do with gin. I don't remember.
Okay.
And a gun so I could kill myself. literary jokes.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah.
Cool.
It was kind of cool. So, yeah, and okay. I have all
that's
these...
kind of clever.
Now I have all these books. Nice. I still haven't read them.
What has stopped you from watching a James Bond movie the whole way through?
I just don't watch movies.
Oh, okay. Well, that'll do it.
Like, I don't even...
I'm the opposite.
Yeah.
I could literally watch nothing but movies. I can't do it.
I'm lucky if I read a pamphlet the whole
way through. If you were to sit me down and say, we're going to watch this movie... Then
that'll
I would.
Happen, yeah.
Yeah, I absolutely
but
would.
It's not an active
I was just
thing
looking at looking yeah. to see. I mean, if I have the extra money, they're selling the whole collection now. Except for Spectre, obviously, because
right.
it's not out yet. But,
of course.
At Walmart for like $94.
That's but pretty it's good not a considering big... there's like 15 movies.
Yeah, but it's not a big. I want the big collector's box, you know.
Yeah.
I want
yeah. like that one that's sitting on your shelf over
yeah,
there.
Yeah,
yes.
Similar to that one.
Yep. We have them all in DVD, I think Blu-ray, VHS. He's got all the books. He has a lighter for each movie. That might be as far as it goes.
He's got a lock of
their Sean
hairs.
Connery's hair. Yeah.
I'm gonna get him a Walther PPK.
Yeah, I think he has cool. one. Yeah.
We're actually going to get the parts to make the golden gun. We have to search yeah. we have to go to the four corners of Canada to find them all. Like, so we need a pen, a razor, a lighter.
So which movies have you seen? Do you
which ones have
know?
I seen? I've seen Casino Royale.
Okay.
I've seen Die Another Day, GoldenEye.
That's all good movie-ish.
Dr. No.
GoldenEye is good.
Another Day. Yeah, it's not a good time.
Those are the only ones
Madonna,
I can think of.
Right?
I can think of.
I think so.
Yeah.
The Living Daylights.
That's a decent movie.
Is it really?
That one's not bad. Is that Living that's the
die?
One? That's the one. No, the Living Daylights.
Isn't
that's
that
one
of the ones
with
Roger...
Christopher Walken? I think.
Yeah.
Isn't Roger Moore the one guy who was in that one?
I think he is. Yeah.
Roger Moore's the guy who everybody hates, or something like that.
No, Lazenby is the one everybody hates because he was in one movie and fucking sucked.
Well,
yeah, but no, there are people.
I feel
though,
like
critics of Roger Moore though, and I don't understand why.
There's people who hate all of them.
Well, I'm just. I only say that. Because...
No, just Sean Connery. Bring him back. He's the best Bond ever.
I maintain Sean Connery wasn't the best Bond ever.
I like Pierce Brosnan.
Yeah. That's my
opinion. Yeah, there you go.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yep.
Same.
He stopped doing a popular television show to be James
which was that con
Steel.
Man guy.
Remington, yeah.
It's a good, they should bring that back, to be honest with you.
That was
he's
a good
not
show.
Up to anything.
No, that, he's too busy doing like...
I think the female lead's dead. I think she's dead.
He was doing like... He is one of the many people who have somehow gained the access to age well.
Yeah.
A lot of people in the entertainment business have not done that.
Oh, yeah.
Like John Cougar Mellencamp. You ever seen what John Cougar Mellencamp looks like these days?
By a cougar.
He looks like a deflated potato. If potatoes could deflate. Like, if you took all the water out of a potato, and, like, a potato's, like, 90% water, you would get John Cougar Mellencamp.
That's so good.
So, you guys see, I saw it on my Facebook feed, but it was available.
Is it about October 21st? Because I'm fucking glad that's passed.
Yeah, that's
it. Oh, I saw one more thing,
fucking
right?
Back to the Future thing.
I love those
movies. I was
going
to go back to the fucking past and kill whoever made that movie.
There you go.
Yeah, I love those movies, but
you
it kind of got
Jaws
over.
19 yet?
Kind of like the same way people have reacted to the Star Wars trailer, too.
Yeah.
And I'm a
negatively? Because that's a big thing.
Is it?
No.
Well, people
that
are
was,
upset
those are
by
two
it because
trolls.
It's different.
That was two. That's honestly was started by two troll accounts on Twitter.
Oh, okay.
The racist, you know, counter.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
I say, they're like, oh, it's anti. I was like, you guys do realize that Han Solo and Luke Skywalker are going to be in the movie, right? I didn't even watch the trailer. I want to be, like, surprised by it when I go there.
I didn't watch the trailer because I don't like Star Wars.
That's fine. I mean, but. What we have now is one of the things I hate in the entertainment business, and especially where it's now all the Fairweather fans have come out to come out of the woodwork. They're like, yeah, we love this stuff. I was like, motherfucker, you didn't watch the movies in 8 years. Like, how are you going to come out now and be like, yeah, I'm a huge fan? You saw all of them once.
Yeah.
Right.
Which, the Star Wars movies?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No, I mean, even the original trilogy or whatever, it's like, I just hate, now that it's a cultural phenomenon, it's like everyone's gonna come out and been like, they've been on board since day one.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, that it's been Star Wars was a huge part of our childhood or whatever when they
I
were.
I saw the movies once.
Yeah, exactly. I mean,
there's
a difference.
I did see the movies exactly once.
That's fine.
I love Captain Kirk.
That's fine seeing them once. Because you're not acting like a rabid fanboy either.
Yeah. Can I tell you what my favorite Star Wars brand integration into a product is? Did you see that for a very limited time, Pop-Tarts was coming out with Pop-Tarts that had a shape in, like extruded on it that looked like when Han Solo was in the Carbonite? It's like, oh shit!
That's pretty clever.
It actually looks really cool.
Well.
Other than that, I don't give a shit about anything like another does ever.
Another thing, though, that I saw, and this is what I'm going to get to.
Hold that thought. Sorry.
That's fine.
Fuck you and your topics.
Yeah, we'll get to a few of them.
What is your reasoning for not liking Star Wars? Because I have a reasoning, too.
I don't give a shit about space, I've discovered.
That's fair.
So you don't really care for anything sci-fi related?
Not really. Mm. Nothing's held my interest in that regard.
Interesting.
I don't have anything against it. But I couldn't tell you one sci-fi themed movie, or specifically
Guardians
space.
Of the Galaxy.
Oh, okay, you beat me.
Ah,
but that was more for the Marvel element than anything else.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah,
but that's still space.
I'd say it's
you're right.
Superhero film than a sci-fi.
Yeah,
fantasy.
But his, I think your point, Casey, still stands. You're right. Other than that, nah, fuck them.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Go on.
Oh, I
your
thought
turn.
You were gonna. What's your reason?
Well, my reasoning is just it's not my type of movie. That's a terrible reason.
Same thing. Yeah.
No, those are fair answers because it's the same way as I would say. I mean, it's not really measurable, but I would say like, oh, the Pitch Perfect movies aren't my kind of movie, or something stupid like.
Right.
I mean, it's a good answer though. It's not, you know, like those movies. If you don't like the movies, that's fine. But I saw on Facebook, too, that someone shared a link to me where it was like, those, you know, I fucking hate these videos, but it's like, teens react to or something this. But it's like, teens react, it's like, Contra's too hard. And I found it funny that, like, today's modern teen, like, if they go back and play an older game, that is what I've heard beyond a shadow of a doubt, that older games used to be harder.
Well, yeah,
because they were supposed to be harder.
They were supposed to be harder. Yeah, there's actually a strategic reason as to why they're
so
harder.
So you could play it longer.
Yeah, you'd have more.
Well,
time
no, I'm saying it's just funny to me to see people who's like They're experiencing gaming as COD.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, we're gonna go way back and give you this and good luck, fucker.
This game doesn't have a pay to win feature.
Yeah.
Bullshit.
How am I supposed to win?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How am I supposed to use my dad's credit card on this?
Yeah. That's pretty funny.
I'm gonna go on my yacht later. There was one of those React videos that had Maisie Williams in it. I think that's her name. The girl who plays one of the people on Game of Thrones.
Okay.
Again, Game of Thrones, not my cup of tea.
Don't care. Yeah.
Don't care.
I have the books. I'm going to try to start reading them, but I haven't.
I've tried,
time to
and
sit
I
down.
Couldn't do it.
Can we make a bet right now? What happens first? The books end or Martin dies?
The book series.
Wow, you're like the umpteenth
ending.
Person to ask that question.
Yeah, I'm sure, but
I mean, here's the thing. I got the collection. It was like $30 at Walmart for the five books that have been out so far.
Yeah,
I was like, all right,
there's seven. They're going to be seven, right?
Six or seven.
Oh. I was like, okay, box set. So I got it. And I sat
depends
down.
Depends on his health. That one.
I sat down with it and I started looking at it and I said, okay, the one book is longer than just to put in reference to another fantasy series. When I was working at Abraxas at night, I read a lot of books. One series was Lord of the Rings. I went through all of them again. And I was like, wow, this is almost longer than all of those put together.
Yeah.
And it's the first book. Like, it's not bad writing, but he does
banders.
A thing that, he does a thing that I hate as a, I've decided to try to start writing stuff.
Yeah.
As a writer, it's like, you're putting so much minute detail into everything that take some people out of the story. Like, you need to be able to turn the page and keep it interesting and don't just describe how ghoulish the villain is or something like this with pages upon pages of adjectives.
I found for whatever reason, whenever a really, really big book comes out, like one that's several hundred pages, maybe even 1,000, people go apeshit because it's like, wow, that's so big. I can't wait to read it.
Right.
Have you noticed that at all?
Yeah.
I don't know if you know.
I had a bad
experience. I'm not well involved with books.
Well, I'm just saying, I'm just asking if you noticed that was the, at all.
Yeah,
the,
I have.
The
I mean,
action.
I...
Because I can remember specifically when the fourth Harry Potter movie, or book came out.
Yeah.
Because when this one, compared to the other ones that had come out so far, this one was like twice as long.
I do remember that.
It was enormous. And I remember seeing a thing on the Today Show where
Harry Potter.
They're standing
the
like,
Wizarding World on Today Show.
These fucking American reporters are standing in King's Cross Station, like, this is the place where it all happens,
right.
And here is the book, and everybody's excited about it. And my mom looks over and they're like, they're just saying that because it's a big book, and I'm like, probably, yeah.
I when I was younger, I got
this is where it all happens,
Steven.
Something to that effect. It was like that. This was like 15
years.
This was like 15 years ago, so
right,
I remember it.
I got when I was younger, I got Stephen King's The Stand.
Oh yeah.
And I was reading that, and it's so long. There's
you
a
had
point.
To sit.
Yeah. There's a. There's a point.
There was like a secondary charge there. Like everybody's like, yeah, that makes. Oh.
There's a point where you're going.
I deserve none of that.
You're going through the story, and it's not spoilers, but it's it's about an outbreak of a deadly disease, and what happens to society because of that from different people's point of views. And then apparently it switches. I never got this far because I put it down. Then it becomes a thing about the devil taking the earth. Like it changes its whole viewpoint.
That's a good old Stephen King.
Yeah, if there's one thing we can tell about Stephen King, just about every one of his books, it's that okay, so stuff happens, weird supernatural occurrence, everything changes. Disappointing ending.
That's funny.
I just watched the Nostalgia Critic's review of Children of the Corn that he put out this week. That's exactly what happens.
Yep.
That's I like the movie, but
I've only read a few of Stephen King's books.
Yeah.
And the only one that I've liked is
Christine?
called Duma Key.
That sounds familiar.
It came out when want to say like 5 years ago or something like that.
Oh, okay.
It's about a dude who loses an arm in a construction accident,
mm-hmm.
and his wife divorces him because he's got mental damage from it.
Uh-huh.
And he's got like one of those phantom
limbs. You're not
the limbs.
Man you used to be.
I was gonna say, is this Metal Gear 5, the Phantom Pain?
Can he fire off his arm like a rocket launcher?
I've seen none of that game still.
It looks terrible, honestly.
It's a lot of fun.
Achievement Hunter did multiplayer of it.
Never played the multiplayer of it.
It looks
fucking
dumb.
That's
because
they shouldn't have made it into a multiplayer game, quite honestly.
You have the ability to like still hide in the box and shit like that, but people know you're in the fucking box
because
it's a bot.
It's revolutionary.
And when you pop out of the box to shoot somebody, I swear to God, it's like a stripper popping out of a birthday cake.
It is. Honestly, I've seen it.
It's like
great.
I'm surprised there's not like a hand flourish alongside it. Yeah. It's kind of dumb.
They absolutely.
It's like Grunt Birthday Party in Halo.
Yes.
They absolutely shouldn't have made it a multiplayer game.
That was
Kojima basically leaving and them taking over with it.
There is a trait, whatever you want to call it, like a special power one of the classes has or something like that in that game where you deploy a kitten. And if somebody discovers the kitten, they pick it up and they get like hearts in their eyes and shit, and they can't do anything for a while. It's fucking dumb. It's fucking stupid.
Yeah,
what is this franchise?
Since Peace Walker, there was a game that came out with like the HD collection.
Yeah.
On Xbox, this is not the one before, but the game before that,
where
it's like, it's mission-based, and you can deploy that. I mean, I do like some of the mission elements of these newer ones.
I'm sure.
But at the same time, the thing that I enjoyed most about 1 through 3 was that it's a concrete fucking story.
Right, yeah.
Like, you can't...
They threw all that out the window.
Yeah. It feels like they're...
But kittens.
Taking it in the direction of, like, almost caught or something. I was like, don't!
Pretty much.
Don't, please!
Yeah, that's basically what it was. There's a way to score more points in that game that's actually pretty funny.
Okay.
You get the points for a kill. You also get points for a knockout, and then going up to the body and attaching, like, a balloon to them.
Yeah, you can...
And then they float for, like, a couple seconds, and somebody has a chance to pop the balloon to stop you from getting the points, but if you don't, they just...
Yeah, that's
it's like 3 seconds. It's like 2 seconds, and they're gone.
That's in the game. In the game, in the single player. That's how like you staff your team at the base and stuff. So it's kind of fun.
Funny.
But yeah, I might sign off.
Japanese.
Oh, yeah.
I might sign off on the series after this game. To be honest with you,
it's too bad. It didn't look great
because it looked like an incredible series up. For the most part, up until then.
Yeah.
I heard the 4 was bad, too.
People say it was because it had a lot of story in it, but it's like the end of Solid Snake, and like the storyline proper, it's the last installment. We're getting very Zelda right now.
Yeah.
But it's the last installment. It's like there's going to be a lot of story into it. And
I will actually, funny you should say that, because I watched my one friend play the very end of that game, like beat the final boss or whatever it was.
Yeah.
And then it was credits, cutscene.
Was it a big boss?
Maybe, I don't know.
No.
I understood the reference, but I don't know.
Yeah.
It was final cutscene, credits.
Yeah.
Credits ended. Cutscene.
Yeah.
More credits.
2 hours cutscene.
Cutscene.
Yeah.
More credits.
Yeah.
Cutscene.
Yeah.
More fucking credits, and then it was over.
Yeah, and then it was Thursday.
It's still going.
Right now it's
2008.
Kojima punishing people. He outright wanted to end the series after the second game, and we've had discussions about that. But it's like, okay, well, fuck with me.
I do like that though.
They, I want to go back real quick to finish what I was saying about.
We have to go back.
About Duma Key.
Oh, yeah.
Because this is a weird, weird plot.
Arm cut off.
Arm cut off. Phantom limb. That's always itchy or something like that.
Alright.
Somebody's like, you should move to Florida and keep your mind off things.
That'll stop your phantom arm from being itchy.
Get into painting or something. I don't know. So he moves down to Florida. on one of the Florida Keys.
Mm-hmm.
Starts painting, meets a Mexican lawyer who tried to kill himself, and suddenly all the paintings that he paints, some aspect of it happens.
Oh, okay.
And there's this old lady who's like some rich entrepreneur's daughter, and she has some sort of skeletons in her closet, and there's a lady in a barrel that the dude drowns because fuck it.
So he becomes a soothsayer?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he actually removes a bullet out of the Mexican dude's head by painting it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's kind of cool.
It's really weird. So, yeah, I've not really... it's been a long time since I read it, but I pretty much finished that book and I was like, the fuck did I just read? Because that just so many parts of it made no sense.
That's a common reaction to Stephen King.
A little bit, yeah, a little bit.
To borrow a phrase Jason Manzoukas in How Did This Get Made podcast, it makes no sense. It's fucking bonkers.
I get it.
I don't get it.
I love that shit. Yeah, oh, I just had this thought. You know what we should have done for this episode since Erica canceled?
What?
We should have tried to get What's-His-Face through Skype from Backup Strats. Tiger.
Tiger?
Yeah. Oh.
Why did you just tell me that now?
Because I don't know.
You never pitched that
I just thought of it right now.
I don't know who that is.
You're not deeply involved with the things that we do outside of the podcast. He's got a speedrunning podcast. I don't know if you've seen that.
No.
And that is the other host of that podcast.
Yep.
So, yeah.
Name is Hypothetical Tiger.
Yeah.
Otherwise known as Aaron. And so every time I get on Skype and I'm like, Aaron! Wow, that was louder than
I thought. The hell was that?
That was Skype.
Oh, you're actually bringing him up.
I wanted to see if he was online.
Oh, okay.
He's probably not, though.
Oh, all right.
Let me find out.
Well, anywho, we're doing AGDQ. I've decided I'm going to join you on your adventures
running. I like what your excuse was for deciding you suddenly wanted to go.
Yeah. I suddenly remembered I don't work over the winter.
I thought it was more along the lines of, I won't spend any fucking money.
That was part of it. And I discovered, but then what else am I going to do?
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna
join you on your week-long adventure, and we're gonna do some good podcasts.
It's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Only problem I'm having about AGDQ right now is that a ton of games that I was looking forward to seeing have already been rejected.
Aww.
Crash 3 was rejected.
What?
Majora's Mask was rejected.
What?
Yeah. Actually, I can bring up the list right now.
Fuck that shit.
I can read to you some of the. It was. It's really dumb.
We rejected fun.
Battletoads is in though. A Battletoads. Oh, race.
Thank fucking God for that.
There's still another round of cuts.
That's the crux of speedrunning right there. Fucking Battletoads.
Oh,
hooray for fucking Battletoads! Hey everybody, we're not gonna have games everybody loves there, but guess what? We got ourselves some Battletoads. Book your hotel room now. Free breakfast, free Battletoads, done as fast as possible.
There's a show in February I'm going to. You guys are invited to come along.
What is
Super Mario 64? We're a little iffy, but don't worry, everybody. We've got Battletoads.
I should.
Are you quite finished?
Because it's a big thing. I just don't have the name off the top of my head right now.
Come on, Google. Work for me.
Work, Google. Go.
Events.
Not working.
Yeah, sounds like it's gonna be fun.
It is gonna be fun.
We're gonna do podcasts while we're there.
I propose that we do a hybrid
Magfest,
podcast.
Of course.
Oh, Magfest is awesome.
Yeah.
Love to go to Magfest.
That'd be fun.
I've already said that I'm going. I mean, I kind of need to have my tax return or something pay for it.
But yeah, this is. I propose that we do a hybrid podcast in which we have people from our podcast on and people from Backup Strats on.
I don't know, I'd probably just do two podcasts, to be honest with you.
I guess we could.
I mean, a hybrid podcast would be pretty cool. But I don't. Your podcast is specialized on a topic, and if we did a hybrid, we wouldn't do that.
That's true.
I don't know. I don't know. I guess if people can send us messages about what we should do with something like that.
I don't know how familiar you are with the speedrunning community, but is there anybody who you would like to see on our podcast. Because I can pretty much ask anybody who is on there.
Do you think Ray's going to be there?
Oh, Ray's always there. I could go ask him.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's fucking Ray Narvaez Jr.
Yeah, he always goes to GDQs.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. He went to GDQs before he quit Achievement Hunter.
Yeah, I believe that is correct, yeah. But and let's go big or go home, right?
Yeah, I don't know how I'd get in contact with him because everybody watches him.
Just meet him there?
I guess I could. I don't know. It would be difficult.
Don't you have a connection? Fi-Fi?
Yeah, Fi-Fi knows him.
Like, talks with, yeah, let's...
I'd have to get in touch with Fi-Fi, of course.
Right, let's do that. We can have... If you don't... I know you've been trying to get Fi-Fi on your podcast for a while and things keep coming up. So yeah, if something happens where you haven't had him on yet, let's get Ray for one of them and Fi-Fi for the other one. I mean, if they're talking to each other, it shouldn't be too hard to get them both.
It's worth a try.
Yeah.
Fi-Fi, by the way...
I'm always thinking.
Who, he recently took a hiatus from speedrunning and started doing this thing called... He called Marathon 64.
I heard about this.
In which he's playing 64 Nintendo 64 games in a month. But halfway through this month, which is when he was doing it, he decided...
I have a better idea.
I'm going to, me and my roommate, we're going to, in shifts, do a non-stop marathon for as long as we feel like. It just ended on Wednesday.
Oh.
It was 252 hours long.
252.
That's about a week and a half.
That's 10.5 days.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
They were going to do exclusively 1 week, Sunday to Sunday, and then they were about to wrap it up, and they're like, I have a better idea. every five new subscribers we get on either of our channels, we'll add an hour. And it just so happened that it added an hour every 2 hours, or something like that, so, yeah.
Good fucking god. That's brilliant. That's how you do it, honestly. I need to get into this.
Summer Games Done Quick was already announced when it's going to be. July 26th to August 1st.
Listen, I'm not decided if I'm going to that or not.
I am. I absolutely am.
Until they confirm Battletoads.
It's probably going to be in St. Paul, just so you know.
Well, where's that?
In Minnesota.
Oh, well, fucking no. What the fucking way?
I'm going to every one that I can get to.
No, that's cool. That's fine. But yeah, I'm actually very excited to be going on this, because we're going to get, I think, a lot of content out of it.
Let's see.
More than anything, you know?
Games that have been rejected. F-Zero GX.
Sure.
I'm just going through the list now. Mega Man Battle Network was 2 was rejected.
That's too bad.
Mega Man X3 was rejected. Caleb Hart, who is a big Mega Man X runner, is, like, really pissed about that.
I'm sure. How can they reject any Mega Man game like that?
Oregon Trail 2 was rejected.
Damn it! I've been quiet all this time and waiting for Oregon Trail.
Sonic Adventure DX was rejected.
Good.
Super Mario Galaxy was rejected.
Really?
Yes.
Good.
What are they gonna have?
Zelda the Wand of Gamelon was rejected.
Hope you fuckers like playing N64 before. That's all we have at this moment.
It's mostly what it is, honestly.
Grand Theft Auto Chinatown Wars was accepted. That's the
pandering! Pandering!
That's the game for the DS.
I'm not even going to be there, but pandering.
By the way, AGDQ this year, sponsored by Rockstar.
Yeah.
AGDQ 2016, rather. God, it sucks.
I'm excited for MAGFest.
AGDQ 2016. Sponsored by bullshit. Nothing you love.
Goldeneye was accepted.
Gonna get a hotel in the next town.
The Simpsons arcade game was accepted.
That's my secret. What? How do you even speedrun that?
Here's the one that everybody is upset about.
It's an auto-scroller. Like, what?
Super Mario Maker 10 random levels accepted.
That's stupid.
That's dumb.
That's stupid.
Portal 2 was accepted.
Okay.
Mario Kart 64 was accepted as a bonus game.
Okay.
I'm just looking for games. A lot of these games, I have no idea what they are. But I'm just going through the list now.
Alright.
Lego Star Wars the video game was rejected.
Those games that you don't know about are sometimes some of the coolest.
It's true.
Like that, the Splatterhouse how to play that I made, I saw that game on a speedrun, and I'm like, I'm going to check this game out, and I thought it was really cool, and I immediately thought of jokes for it while I was watching it, so I'm like, I'm going to make a video on this. So I look forward to those stupid games no one's ever heard of.
Yeah. Pac-Man World 2 was rejected. That's too bad. I like that game.
Okay.
Yoshi's Island was accepted as a bonus game. Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion was rejected. Binding of Isaac Rebirth was rejected.
Really?
Battletoads accepted.
Oh, good. Oh, fine. Great.
Battletoads. Yeah. Fire Emblem Path of Radiance was accepted.
Sure, why not?
Call of Duty Black Ops 2 rejected.
Good. Somebody had some sense.
Super Ghouls and Ghosts was accepted.
Okay.
Sonic CD was accepted.
Okay.
Not bad. Mario Golf, rejected.
Okay.
Blaster Master was accepted. And remember, there's still one more round of rejects or acceptance.
This is great. This is great pod. Right?
I know.
Yeah, that's about as far as we need to read, I think.
Wind
yeah.
Waker was also rejected, which is upsetting.
What the fuck are...
I'm okay. Happy I'm not going.
Okay. Yeah, I know, right? I'm not going now out of protest.
Well, those were just the first few pages.
There's a lot of Winterfest to go to.
Yeah.
I'm still going to go just for the experience, though.
Yeah.
Even if most of the games are pandering.
I'm just going for the breakfast.
Hey, everybody loves breakfast.
Continental, baby.
Oh, fuck yeah.
And they're really nice rooms, too.
Are they?
Yeah.
Cool. Who gets the floor?
I get the floor.
Oh, okay.
I'm just gonna say it right away, so we don't have to argue. I'll take the floor.
All right. Sounds like a plan.
Guys, MAGFest.
MAGFest. Oh, maybe.
I'm in. I'm totally in.
When is it?
Nice. Bring up the event page.
Oh God.
All right.
Yeah.
I saw an ad on a YouTube video last night.
A few people are confirmed that.
Cool.
Are interesting.
Daniel
Davis.
Yeah.
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yes. Yes, he's going. It's fantastic. We were all waiting for him to show up at MAGFest.
He's gonna method act as a musician.
There you go, yeah.
February 18th through the 21st.
Okay.
Maybe. I'll have to see when I start up work again.
Take the days off. Son.
I saw an advertisement on a YouTube video last night for a movie that is coming out. Have you guys seen the ad yet for Pride and Prejudice and Zombies?
That's actually a book. Did you know that?
No. Well, that takes the wind out of my sails.
It's a
Shit.
Book because when Pride and Prejudice went under public domain after copyright ran out, somebody was like, this is the market to put a zombie spin on things. Let's do it.
Oh.
So it's a book. So it's actually an adaptation.
It's going to be a movie now as well.
What is it with people's obsession with zombies?
I don't know. It's not great.
I hate that.
It's not great.
Zombies are... As far as, like, the universe of evil monster things that you could possibly have, zombies are, like, the lower tier. Though, I don't remember where I heard it.
A D&D book.
But there's... Somebody made the theory that the reason zombies are suddenly popular is not only is there's a reason...
Because people can identify with
them. Because capitalism, man.
Well, sort of, actually.
Well, that was George A. Romero's...
Because every age...
He's actually made good movies about that, too. That's the big shock.
Every generation of people have had, like, some focus of monster in horror movies that have been...
Yes.
Somehow...
In the 70s, it was Blackula.
Black Dynamite! Burp, burp,
burp. Tell me you know about Blackula.
I can guess as to what it might be.
You're absolutely right.
Apparently, in the 60s or so, like, the enemy was quicksand. If you ever watch a lot of 60s movies...
I love the concept of the enemy is quicksand.
The enemy is quicksand.
Just, like, don't go there. Like, that's enemy beaten.
Like, you see quicksand in a lot more movies then than you do now.
Yeah.
Because it's lost its horror, whatever.
Right.
And apparently, somebody... I don't remember who, but I'll try to find it and put in the links... Somebody made the connection that every generation of people, they fear a certain thing, and that's what markets market upon.
Okay.
So this current generation is zombies because of, like, the whole mess we're in with economics and politics and how it's just, like, the random person doesn't matter anymore.
Right.
The general public doesn't matter anymore, so we're just the throbbing masses.
Uh-huh.
So it's sort of like...
okay.
Sort of banking on that concept of just mindless attacking people.
Okay. I mean, it adds up.
I think it's giving too much credit to
the general population.
Yeah,
that's what I'm
not.
Say.
They're not. It's not. That's a good theory, but they're not nearly smart enough for that.
Susie Hillbilly McFucknuckle down at the Walmart isn't buying a zombie.
They're just
movie
watching
with that
it. They're just
mind.
Watching it because The Walking Dead's a good show. And it's not, let me turn it on, and it's
thanks,
not.
It's Forrest Gump.
It's fucking terrible. And I'll say right here, it's terrible.
I think that zombies is a good
show.
No,
I was going to say, I'll follow you up with this though.
Uh-huh.
Also, this generation, the thing that I can't stand, and Nostalgia Critic did a review of it, the found footage film.
Oh, yeah.
That's probably on. About out
they
the
can
window.
Fucking suck a dick.
It's probably about done.
I would think. That's his, was his, you know, his
there are, like, what, five Paranormal Activity movies now?
This is the last one, though.
They started with
so
that
they say.
Stupid
no,
ass.
No, they've said. Yeah,
stupid
they,
ass.
They have said, yes, we are done now.
Well, that's good.
Stupid ass Blair Witch Project, which wasn't scary to me
never
when
saw
I saw it.
It
when I was younger. It isn't scary to me. I just watched it last year to see, like, oh, hey, how does this movie hold up, you know, in my view? It's fucking awful. Then Blair Witch 2, which is even worse.
No way.
Book of Shadows.
Yeah.
Is that possible?
What's a Nostalgia Critic review on that one? But the first one...
There's
like,
nothing
yeah,
better
I threw
to
the
me.
Fucking map in the river!
There's nothing better to me than watching a Nostalgia Critic on a horror movie.
Yeah.
I love that.
That's some of the best.
Like the one with It, where it's the reveal that It is like a spider creature.
Oh,
he's just like... No reaction.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
That's thanks, Stephen King.
Good old...
Yeah, fucking...
Good old Steve King.
The clown was great, you know.
Can we
stick
can
with
we
the clown?
Yeah.
Can we maybe have a plot that doesn't take place in Maine? Thanks.
Yeah.
But Maine is the most
Maine
bland
is
state.
Up.
It's the most bland state in existence, and that's saying something. Thinking about that, it has the entire Midwest to contend with, and yet Maine somehow
going strong.
Somehow Maine wrestles its way up to the top with its fishing villages and its Canadian politeness.
Yep.
You guys see another thing that was shared.
At least in the Midwest, they have corn to deal with. Maine doesn't even have that. They got fucking frozen lakes.
They got lobster.
Ooh,
fucking.
Yeah.
That's
true.
I
saw this
true.
Advertised a few days ago, and I wanted to bring it up to see what you guys thought about it. Apparently, there's a new game on Steam now that, like, you download and play once. It's an FPS or something, and when you die, like, it locks out your account, and you can't play again.
Yeah.
I think it's one of the dumbest things I've ever seen in my life.
That was a game in, like, the early 90s
yeah,
or something
I remember
like that.
That. It uninstalled itself, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
We talked about that once.
Yeah.
I mean, the fatal error they made is...
What's that game called?
I forget, but I just saw the premise of it
and
wrote it down, but the fatal error they made is that, you know, on Steam, you can fucking refund your purchases.
Yeah.
So you download it and play it and you die, and then if it's within 24 hours, like, okay, refund, get all the money back.
Yeah.
Good job, developers.
We should play that game.
Yeah.
What's this game I keep hearing about called Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes?
Oh, that's actually a genius use of the Oculus Rift.
That's what I had a feeling it had something to do with that. I don't
it
have
is.
No idea what it's about. I've seen zero gameplay.
It requires two people.
Okay.
One person has the Oculus Rift on. They are in a room with a bomb. The bomb is pretty randomly
generated.
Generated.
Generized.
Whatever.
Making up new words here on the podcast.
That's what we do. To have all sorts of different puzzles, and the puzzles even have different solutions to them based on, you know, what how they look or whatever. The other person has a manual that is a guide on how to get past all of these puzzles and defuse the bomb. So one person with the Oculus Rift on is describing the bomb to the person with the manual, and they are looking through the manual to find out which puzzle it is based on the description, and then based on the specifics of that puzzle, how to solve it.
That is really cool.
It's very good. It's very good. I saw Achievement Hunter has put out two videos. One of them went up today. I haven't seen it yet.
I know Game Grumps did it.
Game Grumps
I haven't
did
watched
it.
Game Grumps in like a month.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I stopped caring. I just
stopped
caring.
Yeah. They're really into Mario Maker right now.
I noticed that.
It's fine.
Everyone's into Mario Maker right now. And I know the moment I get a Wii U, everybody's going to be like, this game's stupid. I know it's going to happen because it happens every time I get a new game.
You're
going to
get a Wii U?
Yes.
I think that's the real question here.
I want Mario Kart 8. And I want Mario Maker. I want Smash.
You want Smash.
I want Pikmin 3.
I'm going to do a How to Play on Smash.
Smash 4?
64. Or
just, Smash 64.
I think 64. It's the one I know the best, and it's the one I have access to footage to. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's still in the very, very beginning planning stages.
Whatever happened to Binding of Isaac?
It's just not done.
Yeah.
That video, I started that video in fucking February.
Yeah.
It's been, like, this killer hump that has absolutely just stalled all progress. Although, I put out a video today, How to Play 3.
Yes.
The goofy, Vine-style 10 games real quick. And it's actually good. It has callbacks to the first one. Mm. So, it's pretty good. Rolls, you watched it before we started. I think you enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I made a Vine recently.
Oh, yeah, you started Vine.
Yeah.
I want to start Vine so badly.
I haven't had a good idea for a new one yet.
It's really just whatever you can come up with, you know?
Well, I haven't come up with anything lately.
Well.
Recently, just the end of this week has ended a segment of about 2 weeks of utter stress.
Yeah.
Because I'm now senior English major in college. Right. So everybody's like, essays, projects, tests, let's go!
You can make something out of that. Do something out of that. Do something you have with the resources that you have.
I could.
That's how it's done.
Let me complain first, and then we'll get to that.
Okay. I had the same experience in college that every college student has. I'm going to complain about it.
That's how you get popular, because you're relatable.
Yeah.
I don't know how to react to that. You're right. You're absolutely right.
Check.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be mean about it, but everybody wrote essays in their senior
project.
Yeah, but have you? I just recently wrapped up writing a 20-page essay.
That's cool. Essays are fun. I love them. Anyway.
Then why are you an English major, you fuck?
My senior project was 25 pages.
That's cool.
That
mine was making a gigantic giant wall of cartoons on the art professors.
There you go.
They fucking loved it. At the very beginning, I was doing cartoons based on actual cartoons I had written before, and they're like, these are terrible. I'm like, the one guy's like, these aren't funny, and that was like daggers in the heart, like, oh fuck you. So it's like, and I was talking with the one professor, and he's like, he wasn't the professor that I talked with about this project. He wasn't there for the review thing. So he was like, I can't fucking believe that they said that. And he's like, what you need to do is something related to them, something that they enjoy. And I'm like, well, they're art professors. What do they enjoy more than them? So it was all on them, and I fucking loved it. I forget the point I was coming around to.
Not about art or anything. But
no,
about,
fuck that.
Like,
no,
fucking tenure
fuck
and
yeah, fuck it. No.
Wages.
It was all about.
I have to be 100 to freaking retire.
All of them. What were we? What was I? What were we talking about before I got on this topic?
College, stuff,
essays,
writing,
vines. Something. It was something about vines.
Relatable.
My favorite vine of all time. All right, that's a good one.
That's a good one.
It makes me laugh every time
I
see
vines,
it.
So.
Is a Rooster Teeth one, where it's Gavin and he's looking at a jar of jelly beans, and there's a sign that says, "Guess how many jelly beans are in the jar?" And then the next shot is just him writing on a piece of paper a big zero. It cut back to the jar. The jar is empty. Cut back to him, and his mouth is just loaded with jelly beans. It's fucking fantastic.
I like the one where it's the set of Barbara puns.
Yes.
Where it's like, hey guys, check out my new spoiler. Snape kills Dumbledore. God damn it, Barb!
As you can see from this graph, this is actually a giant dick.
Those are brilliant.
They do. They're talking about starting those up again. Oh, good fucking God. And I agree. I thought they were fantastic.
So, why do you like writing essays? Just out of curiosity.
It's just fun. In my senior year of high school. No, not my senior year. Was it just my senior year? No, it was every year in high school. One of my classes was to write an essay every week. Two pages, at least. So I got used to it and found it easy. And I found it not hard for me to say what I wanted to say in the space I needed to say it. So it really wasn't any kind of, like, I have to buckle down and write this thing. It was like, I'm just going to sit and write my thoughts on this thing. And I usually hit the length that I want to do.
Okay.
I think that's why How to Plays work out for me so well. Because right. I kind of, I have a writing background, technically, with this, you know, 4 years writing 2 pages every single week. And 6 years of stand-up comedy has kind of built up a comedy kind of thing. And yeah. since I kind of analyze video games pretty deeply, those three things really come together to make a series that I think isn't bad.
It's because you were considered a gifted student.
I was. I'm very gifted.
Yep. You gotta put that on a pedestal, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, who's gonna take you seriously?
Mm-hmm. Oh, good. Fine. God. I rewatched a couple How to Plays last night, and I enjoyed
yeah,
it.
I noticed you posted that on Facebook.
I put them on Facebook again just because I wanted to see if it got any view boosts.
Did you know, by the way, that Rolls has recently gained the ability to sleep with his eyes open?
He's been doing it for the last 10 minutes.
I know. Yeah. He has nothing to add.
Well, he can sleep any other way. I told you about the paint me like one of your French girls position.
Oh, yeah.
And he just talked earlier about... Sleeping up, leaning up against a wall.
Yeah.
Why don't you tell us about your adventures of last night you started to get into before we started?
Oh, okay.
So, and then we can wrap up on that.
I have something else to talk about. Why do we have to wrap up?
I don't know. Because it's like an hour.
Why don't...
And I like you the know, hour you know, to an hour and a half system.
I was just thinking.
Uh-huh.
Our longest podcast ever was 3 minutes shy of 2 hours.
We're not going to beat it this week. There's
who's
no
to say,
fucking way.
Who's to say... We don't break all the rules.
Well, I have a lot left to talk about. Honestly.
Yeah, see, let him talk.
Oh, God. All right.
You can sit there and you can deal with it.
You guys talk. I'm gonna get cookies.
I was going to say, I didn't need to.
Better share.
Okay.
Here you are. Oh, I was in the gifted classes. Boo, boo, bee, boo.
Was I a robot? Like, what the fuck?
Where are you? Where are you now? What have you done for me lately? Now, last night, I went on a adventure.
Oh, yeah?
I drove my buddy and myself to a show in Hewitt, Maryland.
What?
Right next... right...
Hewitt!
It's near Hagerstown. So we got there. And we stopped at Sheets and we got some stuff. And then we went to the show and... We're hanging out. Couple of details. I especially would go outside and my buddy Brandon in his truck and just get cans of beer from that rather than drinking the expensive beer in the bar.
Okay.
And
breaking the law.
Yeah.
The comedy laws.
We basically hung out outside. After the first two bands, I basically hung out outside for the rest of the night. That and, like, at the bar and kind of palling around and stuff. Brandon, who went up, did his whole set in nothing but a jacket and a man thong.
Whoa!
Do research on, like, G.G. Allen. He kind of does it in that style, except not okay. completely naked.
All
right.
Hold on, back up.
So he's jumping all around.
Back the
crazy.
Soul Train up, Don Cornelius. I think that's how you say that.
Yeah.
Why? No,
that's just his the style he was going for was very G.G. Allen-esque. Which
I've never heard
why
of that
was,
guy.
Why was G.G. naked during shows, you know? While singing hateful music.
Because fuck it, or?
Yep.
Kinda.
For shock value, or?
Yeah.
Some obscure art form? Making a statement?
There is definitely making a statement involved with the music, but I think G.G. was a little... too into Gigi when he was doing the shocking stuff, too.
The reason that I wear no clothes is because I'm exemplifying...
He didn't talk like that.
The bareness of society.
He would walk up to you, punch you in the face, call you a faggot, and then probably try to fuck you.
Like Rolls, if he began... Well, actually, I'm not gonna finish that. After that last segment of that sentence, I'm not
but
gonna...
I tried to get a mosh pit because I had my boots on and I was wearing... Oh, by the way, I was dressed
as... I was wearing my moshing boots.
I was wearing my Jason Voorhees outfit, too.
You're going to try to go crowd surfing, you end up stepping on everybody.
My denim jacket literally covered And
well, shit.
This high in blood, the container of blood, half more than half of it,
hold on,
covering the jacket.
I think you're leaving out some details.
Yeah, it's like, where did said blood come from?
Oh, it's just Halloween decorations.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I was going to say.
That, you know, I have my
one
mask.
One of the black metal bands decided to bring their own blood.
They brought a sacrifice.
They brought a goat.
Yeah.
They
didn't leave with a goat. They brought
the mask,
a goat.
The mask, it was already done from last year, because I had some paint brushes, and I kind of painted that with blood, too, and it was a big fun time. I left the machete in the car, because I figured...
Rolls, that's how we refer to you when you're not around. The big fun time.
This just in, everyone on Groupcast is gay.
It's not an insult, really. So I was there, it's Jason Voorhees. There were times during the time to see the shows, I would put my glasses down next to my beer and walk out, put my mask on, and I would be Jason Voorhees in and out in the crowd. It was a lot of fun.
Right.
It was a lot of fun.
Rule 17, the Jasoning.
So he did the whole show, you know, and his thing, and people were afraid to mosh. I was like, he even said it.
Well, you had your boots on. Yeah,
he even said it.
You had your washing boots
around.
On.
It's like, come on, we can all touch each other on this one.
Whoa.
There's nothing wrong. Sometimes you get a finger in your butthole. He's like walking around having fun. You know, it was a good night.
I want that to be his album title.
It was a good night. And, you know, then we went outside. We were hanging out outside for a while. Fat Zach was very drunk.
Fat Zach.
He came
fat
in,
and drunk?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's reduced fat now, though. He's getting smaller.
He's saturated fat.
He came in. We came in, we were sitting at the bar just hanging out.
Trans
and,
fat. That would be if he decided to be a woman. He'd be trans fat.
There are these guys. There are these guys walking around in denim jackets, right? And it's on the back, Norseman. And then there's a woman walking around, and she had the same jacket. But underneath it, she had a thing that's like property of whatever the guy's name. So I said, oh shit, this is an old school like biker gang. Nice. And then I started palling around with him a little bit and talking about heritage and, you know, I was kind of fucking with him. And went outside, bummed a smoke off the one guy, very begrudgingly gave me the cigarette. So I was basically bullying an underling right in front of his boss. He probably didn't make it home that night. I mean, it is a lot of fun. I wanted to really fuck with him more, but I don't know. I'd take my gang over their gang anytime. You know?
Are we your gang, Rolls?
No, not really. You guys weren't there. These are people I trust in. Not that I don't trust you guys to have my back in a fight, but it's like, these guys are battle tested, you know?
We are battle toads.
Yeah.
Speed running,
yeah. Our posse doesn't ride on motorcycles, we ride in wagons. So I'm not talking about, like, car wagons, I'm talking, like, radio flyer wagons.
Like, pool wagons.
Yeah.
So then I got a little, you know, I kind of hung out and drank some water and got good to drive. Followed Brandon in his truck back to his place and hung out there. We put in Conan the Destroyer on DVD.
Watching that.
And then it was like two guys just sitting on a couch literally commenting over a movie.
Nice.
While talking about women who are easy.
That stuff's fun. Right?
Apparently my landlord's a very easy hookup, so I'm trying to knock that out.
Someday we're going to watch Queer Duck the movie.
I know.
Someday.
Right?
It was a good night.
It's been 32 episodes.
Oh, that's a long time.
But
it's
like
a year
for
us.
It was one of those where I got home at 4 in the morning, so I kind of had to
almost
just
was,
kick the
was
boots off and like stumble into bed. And I didn't put my clothes, I did laundry earlier that day and I put my clothes away, so I just kind of like grabbed and threw everything on the ground and laid down.
That's what I do. That's absolutely what I do.
It's like, who cares? They're going to get folded eventually. It's not this weekend, probably.
They're in the pre-folding
wrinkles.
Stage.
Pre-folding, yeah. Wrinkles. They're in the
folding
wrinkles
prep. Go away when I put the shirt on. Mom. You know? So that's what I did. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the party at your house, honestly.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, your Halloween party's going to be a lot of fun.
We're going to get crunk.
Oh, I just remembered a something.
I got a question.
I remembered a something.
I got a question.
Yeah, okay.
This year, your Halloween costume is very impressive.
Yes. It's a big daddy.
Okay.
I
don't know if you're going to give that away or not.
Yeah, I can give it away. Dressing as a big daddy.
From Bioshock, which is fucking great. I can't wait to see it finished.
It's in my garage in pieces. I just need to put it together.
Okay. You were keeping it a secret for a long time because it was this big, impressive thing.
Yeah.
I said, can I guess?
Yes.
And you
guessed correctly.
And I guessed correctly, but you told me no. Just to keep it going.
Right.
When I guessed it correctly, in your head, did you still go,
yeah, I did.
You really?
Absolutely, I did.
Yes! I win.
So you basically just asked me that question for pride's sake.
A little bit. I just wanted to know.
You disgust me.
I found that yesterday when I was wearing the bloodstained jacket and the mask, and thankfully not with the machete at the time, I really was becoming the character in my head. Yeah. Like,
I'm gonna murder that dog.
It's a shame. Yeah. No, just teens that have sex before marriage. That's Jason's way. All the kids. They in every single. I love the films. Every single movie. It's kids. Bunch of kids. Let's go smoke weed and fuck in Camp Crystal Lake, where the murderer lives. Just get off my land. Is basically what he does.
Jason.
Man, you know.
Jason's killing those sodomizing teens, because that's not God's way.
Yeah, he's Ronald Reagan's avenging angel.
Man, I would love to do some murder right now, but I just don't want to mess up my moshing boots.
Yeah.
Got a great idea.
They got cleaned
off. Murder in the lake.
Yeah.
They'll clean themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
But I made a lovely discovery recently.
Oh, good.
Two people are coming to this Halloween party that you guys don't yet know, but they may end up coming on the podcast every so often.
Yeah.
Thank you for that. I think it was very fitting that I became friends with these two people because one of their last names is, of course, Perkins.
Ooh! That's
and
cool.
I was like, this is
any
the
relation to the restaurateur?
Well, she told me that she was upset that every time she goes in there, they don't give her a discount.
That's what I would
she
do.
Apparently, she asked for one every single time.
Mm. So she's
how does she ask
Perkins
for
more than once is what I've gathered here.
Yeah,
how does
which
she
is too
ask
many.
For one? She should just do like the snobby rich girl. Well, I'm going to have to talk to Granddaddy about this.
Granddaddy Perkins.
Granddaddy Perkins.
Because
he's just an
obviously
old decrepit building.
You don't know who I am. But I will know who you are. You understand what I'm
back,
saying?
Back when Granddaddy Perkins moved to these United States back in 1853.
He lived in Maine, but he found it way too fucking boring.
There were too many murders and supernatural occurrences.
He had to get away from the Langoliers.
Not
so he moved
boring.
Out west.
The Langoliers and the Tommyknockers.
Yes.
They tore great. Together.
Not out west.
They're a really good Who cover band.
Oh my god. Okay, so Perkins,
so
right?
So Perkins, yeah. They're both coming to the party.
Shout out to Erica.
Okay.
Shout out to Erica Howell.
Perkins. Wasn't that her thing?
She
just says it constantly. So
she just always says Perkins.
She's the walking meme, that's why.
I mean, you came up with the joke.
I did come up with the joke.
So
yeah. Now that I remember it, I came up with the joke in the car with Erica on the way to the podcast.
So Erica really expounded on it, I'm guessing.
A little.
She like latched onto it and was like, this is my new meme.
We went on for a little while in the car ride down. We're like, this is going to be a topic now.
We're going to do it for the Maymays, guys.
All for the Maymays. And those rare Pepes. The rare Maymays.
the rare Maymays. Like Perkins and Duck Roll.
You know who we gotta have on the podcast?
Yeah.
Keith Paradise.
Yes, obviously, yes.
Yeah. I just thought of that because he says Maymays unironically for months before we're like, you know, it's not pronounced that way.
Yeah, I gotta check in
this,
with him.
This man who stops for traffic lights in Grand Theft Auto.
You know, I actually played Grand Theft Auto 5 recently, and I found myself not going on sidewalks and things.
Nice.
Just drove normally. Oh, and then I realized...
You don't want the wanted level.
And I was like, wait a minute. What am I doing? I'm an adult. I'm a thug. Driving a car.
I've never played a Grand Theft Auto. I want to do a gaming segment with Keith Paradise.
Yeah.
Where he yells at games.
That would be lovely.
I'm going to have him play Portal, I think. See how that works out. Who is this bitch? And why is she telling me what to do?
You got
to
check in with him again. I haven't seen him in a while. I love this.
What's this cunt's name? GLaDOS.
GLaDOS.
I'm going to come to your house. And I'm going to take a pool cue. I'm going to shove it. Just right up her technological asshole.
That'll start talking about fucking Baylor and shit.
it's gonna be insane. It's just you gotta talk with all your bottom jaw. It's gonna be insane.
All jaw. What were you saying, Rolls?
Oh, I was waiting for my turn. Because I figured when you guys fucking interrupted me.
Turn. This is like Uno. We skip you.
Yeah. I still have something I need to get back to.
You get skipped, and then I reverse, and then it's Casey's turn again, and then he skips.
Draw four.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was going to say, I haven't seen him in a while, but he finally posted another one of his pictures. And what I'm calling...
Dumpster Fire.
And what I'm calling the Great Fire series.
I love it.
We're going today, already in progress, 10:32 in the morning with a dumpster fire. What the fuck is going on?
I don't think we've ever explained that on the show.
So Keith Paradise, when he's having a bad day, he posts a picture of a dumpster fire with the caption of, "We now return you to Keith Paradise's day already in progress." And my favorite thing is when he told me that, like, the fourth time that he did it, his mom posted on, like, "Wow, people set a lot of dumpsters on fire near your work." And he's like, "No, it's not."
That was the most Pitt thing I've ever seen Pitt football do.
The Pitt man. That's what we call Keith Paradise.
Nice.
Poor guy.
I want to go back just a little bit.
Okay.
Because the same Perkins girl I was talking about.
Oh, yeah. God.
She told me a great story. Now, I kind of don't want to take this away from her because she might actually tell it on the show. But I'm going to do it anyway.
Are you sure? Can we just encourage her next week?
I guess I could. Well, fuck it.
I'm slapping shit down. No. Not on my podcast.
Good old Kwembe Gazumbo, whatever his name is.
Bakembe Matumbo.
Yeah, that guy.
For some fucking respect.
How I remember that, I'll never know.
You guys hear about Lamar Odom?
Yeah, how he's almost died.
Yeah.
You hear about Moses Malone who did die?
Syndrome. Yeah, no, how he went on a, he went on a nice big heroin and meth and cocaine.
Bender.
And hooker bender.
Yeah.
You just blended them all up.
This would be the only time cocaine has ever saved a marriage.
The last words heard before he went into his coma was, "I can't take that much ass."
No, he's dating the unattractive, well, the most unattractive Kardashian. Let me check myself. Right. Force direct myself.
Right.
She looks like a cow. She's all big. She's like the big... She's like the inside linebacker of the Kardashians.
She's the fullback, as you can
tell. Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, the other one's the one with
she
the
looks
fullback.
Like a cow. That was great.
Now, Kim's the one with the fullback.
Oh, yeah.
That dumb bitch. She's doing the... I don't smile because smiling... And the other girls I know follow this. I don't smile because smiling causes wrinkles. Well, have fun being fucking miserable cunt all your life, man.
They'd smile if they had battle tones.
Yeah, there you go. Still on that, are we?
Any chance I get?
I'm going to make a fuck tape with Ray J. Who's Ray J? My point exactly.
Who's Kim Kardashian? Well, now we know.
You can call him Ray. You can call him...
Look, I can inhale a 10-inch black penis. Okay?
Good for you.
I want that sound bite isolated now.
So can the... Half the porn is on the internet, I guess? I don't know.
Half the porn.
I like how,
I don't know. I don't
like how porn is plural. Half the porn.
I don't watch interracial porn. I'm an American.
Speaking of the porns, I was really hoping Erica would be on this episode because I discovered a porn star that looks like her.
Just all nose.
Yes, actually. Yes. Absolutely.
Well, how do you think Erica pays for the bills?
Does this one scream help, too?
We're going
getting
down.
Fucked, she's getting fucked from behind. She starts talking about maymays and shit.
We're going down a bad road. We don't want to go this way.
I pulled my car over, I'll tell you that. I'm not going down the road any further. I've got three things in the queue, and that's where
they're going to Erica, come
stay.
At me, bro.
That's where they're going to stay.
I'm upset she's not coming to the Halloween party.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What, she got a resume to write or something?
I think so.
She has to hang out with her, truthfully, very uninteresting friends that we met at her Halloween her other party.
Her birthday party.
Yeah.
Every time she's not on the show, this is what we do.
We talk about her.
We talk about how much she sucks.
We do that with just about everybody, don't we?
We don't do that with the other participants about this podcast. We don't do that.
To Rolls.
Do you?
It's happened.
It's happened before. It's mostly been Wes Williams, though.
Well, Wes is fun. Wes will make it funny.
It's
so
true.
I can
he
deal
does.
With it.
Oh yeah.
And that's my thing in life and in general.
Yeah.
If as long as it's actually funny, I don't
and
care.
And meant to be.
Yeah. I don't care.
Yeah.
Like that's yeah. Comedians rag each other. That's
yeah.
fucking
yeah.
The job.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But yeah, that I think she's afraid. To be on a podcast with me, Erica, to be quite honest.
Well, I couldn't tell you how many times
she's
like,
canceled
for, like,
after
comedy
yeah.
shows and stuff like that, where it's like, yeah, I'll go. Rolls is going. I'm busy.
Yeah, what the fuck?
And I really think
and we're
is,
generally cool
really
with each other,
yeah,
so I don't understand.
I really do think it is like the biggest coincidence of all time.
It's like
but
a
it's
conspiracy.
So funny.
It's like a conspiracy.
And then. We talked before. Her friend that was hanging out, like, I'm gonna. I love this story because
yeah.
you're involved in it. You really stuck up.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm. And he's like, hey, I can outdrink you. And she's. You're like, no, you can't. You really can't outdrink Rolls. Don't try to do it. You're gonna hurt yourself.
I like how the first time you ever told that story, your reaction was, and me hearing the call, the call, it's
the
like,
battle
excuse
cry.
Me.
Yeah.
I believe I have this thing to say.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But then I think that's, I admit that might, that to be realistic, that might actually be causing Erica some apprehension about seeing me?
I don't know.
I hope not.
We've all agreed
I don't
on,
really
like,
care.
On the four occasions we brought up this party that chick was a cunt.
Yeah, so I mean...
Yeah, I went to high school with her. I can concur.
Even Erica was
I
like, yeah,
hit that,
she
though.
Was probably a twat, wasn't she?
I could have hit that, though. And she was like, oh, you're against... He was agreeing. You're against gay people. It's like... Are you... I told him, like, are you aware one of my closest friends is a lesbian? Yes, I hate her from
yeah,
the,
oh, yeah.
the bottom of my heart.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to get with this chick anyway.
Okay.
From when I knew her in high school, she had this boyfriend who was like the epitome of skater posers, and he drove one of those
Geo cars.
Are you
saying I rock?
What?
And I rock?
Comparatively.
Okay.
I'm just saying you could do better.
I rock comparatively.
That's our
next shirt.
No, that's our title.
That's our next fucking shirt.
I rock comparatively.
No, the I rock. You're not familiar with that vehicle?
No.
No.
It's probably something like what he was driving.
It's from the Middle
East.
It was
yeah. one of those super subcompact cars.
Oh, okay. I thought it
yeah.
was...
Oh,
it,
yeah.
it was like...
The drivable briefcase, basically.
It was a... It was like...
Scion. And then there's music and lasers.
Dancing
and
hamsters. Fuck those hamsters.
Fuck those,
James
yeah.
Franco for some reason.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I want to drive a microwave, but I can't put wheels in it.
Can that be our title? I want to drive a microwave? I don't know.
I don't care what our title is.
Grasping
at
straws at this point.
Roll shows up and makes everything better.
I thought it was
what
one of those
I
two
do?
Things, or beep, beep, boop, beep, or whatever the fuck
beep,
he said.
Beep, boop, beep, boop.
Yeah.
Beep, boop, beep. I forget, I got that off of the car.
Or a comic.
Yeah, because I know you've said it before.
I'm in the Mickey Mouse Club. Boo, boo, bee, boo.
Yeah, the car he drove was like a Robin's Egg blue, and he dropped out of high school and is like, hey, come with me. And he's like, I like older.
Listen, I got a Robin's Egg blue Scion. I got my shit together.
No, it was a Geo.
Oh, whatever.
I remembered that much because I was like, what the fuck is Geo? Yeah.
Do you think Geo has a website on GeoCities?
Probably.
GeoCities is shut down.
I don't care. I
Angel Fire still exists, though.
I use the Wayback Machine to check out sites all the time.
As we discovered when we searched for Dr. Enough.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
But yeah, he was like a bit of a scummy dude. I don't know why I'm talking about this, but I'm going to do it anyway.
No,
yeah.
It's fine.
He was a bit of a...
It's painting a picture of this character that she is a cunt. Yeah. And she associates cunts.
He was a bit of a scummy dude. Like, he dropped out of high school. Smoked a lot of weed and was like, hey, come with me. We're going to have adventures. And she's like, I like popular and slightly older than me, kids. I'm going to go away.
Hey, I'm popular and slightly
she
older.
Smoked heavily.
I did it. I did it.
Tinker Squad. Cheer.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Oh, boy, girls. Boys. What about them?
You know,
nothing.
The rest of the podcast
I like the sound of the word. Boys. All right, I'm done.
So what? Are you done?
No. Why?
I want to get to this other show.
You
end it
so
fun.
Easily.
It's so fun.
I have another thing that I want to talk about because this blew my mind the first time I saw it.
Buckle up and feel the hard dick of podcast.
I'm sorry. Are you in charge of this podcast?
No.
No. Fucking no.
No.
No. This is a website I recently discovered called the Library of Babel. Have you heard of this?
I've heard of the Tower of Babel.
Yeah, well, this is a little bit
different.
That's
as far as my knowledge
goes. So, the Library of Babel is a website in which this dude made some sort of algorithm where it's like a virtual library where there's like rooms, like six-sided rooms. Each room has four walls and two doorways.
Okay.
And each wall has... five bookshelves or something like that, and each bookshelf has five shelves, and each shelf has like 32 books on it or something like that.
Or you could say each room has a lot of books.
Well, this is okay, whatever. and each book is filled with random letters, so you could find any combination of words or letters anywhere. It has every letter of the alphabet, a space, a period, and a comma as the possible letters and characters you can find in each book.
So your goal is to basically flip through these things and try and find a coherent sentence randomly pop up?
But what's great is that you can flip through books, not only just flip through them, but you can also search for certain things. So you could potentially find any combination of words imaginable.
Yeah.
You could find Lennon Free,
right.
Casey Coulter, Justin Rolls, Groupcast, and even the sentence I'm saying right now.
Oh!
just so you guys know.
Oh, that's terrifying!
Shine it! Shine it!
Burn it with fire!
What I did was I just spun around my laptop to show show Lennon and Rolls a page out of a certain book out of this infinite set of books that you can find on this website.
That has that exact sentence
that I just said.
Said. Oh my god.
So yeah, you can search for any amount of words as long as it fills up
Back to the
a
future.
Page.
That is
each book, by the way, has 410 pages, so it's possible to find any combination of words. Most of it is gibberish,
of course.
But yeah,
that is terrifying.
So somewhere in one of these books is the cure for cancer.
Yeah.
How to make
literally
meth.
The cure for cancer.
How the ingredients on how to make meth.
Yep.
And all of Shakespeare's works in order.
Yeah.
So, also, on kind of crazy and mind-blowing stuff.
Yeah.
I've been reading a report from the SETI Institute, the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. They are a couple days away from finding out if... I don't know if you guys have heard about
the...
I
read about this a little.
There's an interesting...
structure.
Sort of, yeah. It may be a structure, it might be...
whatever.
Generated by the universe naturally, or could be artificial.
Tell me about this, because I don't know.
It looks, honestly, kind of like a ring, and when I shared it, I was like, Halo! It's a fucking Halo! But, they are sending signal, like, they will know, based on the signal algorithm that comes back in a few days, if it's artificial and producing its own, like, radio waves, or however they analyze it. I'm not sure. I'm not a...
So, it's a structure they found somewhere that looks like a ring?
Kind of. It looks artificial. Like, they're puzzled by it.
If it was made naturally, it's a pretty decent... I mean, it could exist naturally, but it's a little... It's a bit of an anomaly.
Anomaly is the good word for it.
Yeah.
Because it is... People are... I've shared the article with a few people, and other people... these people have told me... it terrified them to think about.
Yeah.
And... I mean, I think it's just interesting. I, for one, welcome our new overlords.
Overlords, I knew you were going to say that.
What was the distance of this object from
I'm not
us?
Sure.
I don't remember that. Like, I don't
if
remember.
It wasn't the longest point we've ever
if
measured,
it's, if it's
but it
like,
wasn't close
it's
either.
Like, if it's like several, like tens of hundreds of light years, then it must be pretty big, right? Or they just happen to find a shape.
The way that they found planets and stuff before is they'll study the light from a star, and they'll see the either like the shadowing effect or the slight pull of gravity exuded by another planet, and that's how we found that. But I mean, I'm all about space, but I get a kick out of even like they've even done great cracked articles about it, where it's like, here are the insane planets that exist.
Yeah,
there's the
hot Jupiter.
Yeah, there's one that's basically hell. It's everything on it is so radioactively charged. It's black.
Not only
and the skies
is,
are red.
if we're gonna get on space stuff, let me drop some knowledge on you.
Oh, no. All right.
Yeah, we're gonna keep going.
Oh no,
fuck
we're
you.
Getting on space stuff.
I know. You're so sad about it.
Ugh.
So, there's... Not only is there a potential diamond planet, it might be Neptune. Like,
I didn't know.
The core of... it's either Neptune or Uranus, I don't remember which one, has a core that might be made of diamonds.
That's cool.
Also, there's a galaxy that was discovered a while ago, like 50 years ago or something like that, called Hoag's Object, which is...
Oh, Hoag.
Most galaxies are either elliptical, where they're, like, really bright and, like, have a large amount of stars, just, it looks like a bright spot, and then there's spiral galaxies, and then there's irregular galaxies where they're just, like, a mass of stuff.
Yeah.
Doesn't have any sort of shape. Hoag's Object is an elliptical galaxy with a circle of space, of stars around it. And there's empty space in between the elliptical galaxy and the ring of stars.
That's really fucking cool.
Yeah, I know. There's a couple of them. It's not just that one. There's a few.
Oh, I'm sure, yeah.
So that's really interesting how that must have happened.
Space stuff is the most mind-blowing things to think about.
It was proposed that that happened by a galaxy flying through another galaxy, pushing several stars through it.
Yeah.
So there's just this ring left behind, and eventually it's just going to fall apart because...
It's not really sustainable.
It's like throwing a tissue through water.
Yeah.
Like, eventually it's just going to, like, go back to equilibrium.
Oof. Well, that's going to happen to the Milky Way. I mean, we'll be dead. It's going to happen with the Andromeda Galaxy, and I've seen...
Well, no, it's very unlikely that stars are going to collide with each other.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, they said, we'll pass right through it, and it'll be fine. It's like, but there's a lot of gravitational pulls going on at the same time, so it's like... We could go through it, or it could fucking fling the planet literally through space at a million fucking miles an hour.
Have you guys ever heard of rogue planets?
Yes.
Yeah.
Rogue planets are planets that...
When they touch you, they absorb your power.
I was going to say they play by their own rules.
they fly through space.
They have a weird southern accent.
They're not orbiting any other star. They're just floating out in space.
Their core is made of sugar.
Yeah. They have this weird Cajun guy that hangs out with them a lot.
Ew.
I only got back into that.
Oh, yeah?
After, like, 2 weeks off.
Spec Ops started yesterday.
I know, I gotta play it, but I've
Marvel Avengers Alliance. This podcast is sponsored by Marvel Avengers Alliance. Play that game because it's fucking great.
I wish we were sponsored by them.
I got Rogue, and I was able to beat the mission with her, like, level one Sentinel encounter.
That's a tough one.
Yes and no, because with Gambit, you can just stack the cards on
her. That is pretty easy, yeah.
And her attack is fucking through the roof naturally.
She's amazing. Yeah, Rogue is very amazing in that game. Yeah, she's definitely top tier. For a while, I considered doing, but then it became, in my head, I think it was going to be really hard to keep up with. When something updated in that game, I was going to do a short YouTube video about the updates, what was new in it, what had changed, and what it was going to mean for, like, a tier list and things like that.
That's worth doing.
I think so, because I forget what I was looking up, maybe, like, a strategy or something like that on YouTube, and there's one guy who basically has the monopoly on this subject, and he sucks. He's boring as shit, and most of the time, he doesn't go into depth about things. Basically, if a new character comes out, he goes, all right, well, this is a new character. Here's the passives, and he'll read them word for word, and go, all right, here's the attacks, and he'll read them word for word what they do. It's like, I can just go in the game and look this up, too. I mean, I could just do that. Yeah. But, you know, if I was saying, this works with this strategy not so great here, this changes this whole fucking universe of skills, you know, whatever.
I'd like to join you on that, and I'd like to do, what teams are you going to run for this? What are you going to run? I mean,
I'd do a character of the week.
Here's Iron Fist, how they and what he does and all this stuff. It'd be like NFL Today or something.
A little bit.
At Marvel Alliance.
I was actually.
Can we have two really annoying former players join us?
One has a lisp.
We could get Casey and Matt.
I am pretty annoying.
They don't play anymore. I don't think.
Well.
Oh yeah.
You should.
I want to be the Michael Irving.
I'm gonna be John Madden.
Actually, the football. The football.
Who is the football Marvel superhero? NFL Pro, I think, was his name or something like that.
What?
Yeah, it was dumb. It was fucking stupid. People want him in Marvel Avengers Alliance. Anyway, yeah, I think it would be pretty cool. But I saw this post on the Wikipedia page, which is, I think, a fantastic thing.
Man, their Wikia page is awesome.
It's very well done. Very well organized, it's very well run.
Useful.
It's great. It's fucking great. I saw an argument between two people, and Rolls, I'll take your opinion on this.
All right.
Somebody was talking about an alternate outfit, which comes with new powers for a character.
Right.
Came out for a very recent release, Hyperion. I don't know if you've seen that. It makes him actually pretty good.
Yeah.
To a character who before, in the limited amount of time that I used him, was kind of iffy.
Yeah, I never got him. I know about him, though.
I mean, he's fine-ish. Yeah. And his alternate costume makes him actually pretty solid, I think, and easily buildable to be very solid. The comment that started it was somebody going, I'm glad he's got this alternate because he kind of sucks.
Right.
And some dickweed jumped in going, listen, no characters in this game suck. It's just if you know how to use them and who to pair them with or not.
No, some characters suck. When they first, that was a more valid argument maybe when the game first came out.
Right.
But even then, you could see shades of no matter what they do, She-Hulk should never be the bruiser that you run Captain Britain or somebody.
Yeah, exactly.
He'll always be better.
Yeah.
Just because
there's always better options.
It goes with the program. I understand what they're saying, and it's the Pokemon argument, and I can understand that.
Right.
Then I started playing competitively.
Yeah.
And
there's tears for a reason.
Yeah. Tears you can kind of get away.
Yeah.
You can get away with mixing it up a bit and using more of your favorites, but you don't...
It doesn't work.
Yeah.
It just doesn't work.
You don't have to... Because odds are some of your favorites will also be really fucking good.
Yeah.
Because that's why you like them.
Exactly.
Jolteon or something, for instance.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and it's like, okay, we'll have him on your team, then you can build around your center, yeah.
Yeah.
But like that terrible Orange Islands arc where the guy just had Dragonite and was like, I've got Dragonite, I can beat anything. Then Pikachu jumped on his head and shocked him through his antennas. That is bullshit. It's the only championship that Ash has won that I call foul.
Now,
Pikachu beat a dragon.
To go back to Marvel on this topic, though, a lot of unique strategies you can come up with, they just don't work.
Yeah. The top tier stuff is really top tier for a reason, and it's going to stay that way.
Here's how alternate should work, in my opinion. If you have... Okay, here's a good example. Kitty Pryde.
Yeah.
Her alternate is fucking amazing.
It is amazing. It makes her go from useless to really good.
Nightcrawler.
Yeah.
Same thing.
He's pretty decent all around, but yeah.
Before, though...
Yeah.
He was okay.
When they released the alternate, they did change the characters drastically. When you have the swashbuckler. Yeah.
Yeah. An alternate outfit should... In theory, and this is my opinion with DLC and everything too,
yeah,
and games in general, the alternate should, unless it's just for cosmetic sake, like Street Fighter alternate costumes or something.
Street Fighter, beep, boop, beep.
It should shake up the tier list, honestly.
It should.
I need to use that more often, I'm sorry.
It's fine. It should be able to breathe new life into the character and let you use it in a different way.
And most of the time it does.
But there are just some people who are released that are going to be bad.
Yes.
Like, if there's going to be a great character, it's got to be a bad character, too. Because then we don't know... They can't all be just great battlers or whatever.
Yeah, really. In the Spec Ops that launched yesterday, Baron Mordo is a lockbox. He doesn't look great. I mean, he's fine. He does all the stuff he did as a boss.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing, like, new really going on there. Not impressed.
Yeah.
He's not going to be a top-tier threat, and he's the newest character.
Sort of on the topic you were just saying, the other thing that's fun, having weak characters in games that where you play competitively.
Yes. And then using them to kick somebody's ass.
Yeah, exactly.
It's incredible.
Right. Like Roy in Smash 3? Smash Brawl?
Roy wasn't in Brawl.
No.
Ike is great.
Ike is great?
Yeah.
I thought he was in a low tier.
He hits like a motherfucking truck.
Watch Brawl Taunts, and you'll see why.
Oh, yeah. That's even Matt Fitz.
He goes over like all his bonuses. I had this great deflector and a projectile, and I can fly. What can I do? And then Sam is like, maybe grow some balls.
Oh, that was Pit.
Yeah.
No, I was saying, my brother is into competitive battling a lot.
Yeah.
So he's recently just done experimentation with the dumbest combinations of Pokemon.
Yeah.
Like, I wish I could remember some.
That's what I did when I did.
Lickitung.
Oh.
He has my favorite one is the star player in his one competitive battle team is Perugly.
They're okay from what I've heard, actually.
The fat-ass gray cat.
One of the ugliest Pokemon in existence, I think.
Thus being called Perugly.
Yeah, oh yeah, exactly.
Where its cry is, bam, bam!
I've told you about my awesome Bibarel I built, right?
Oh, no.
Oh my god, this thing was the biggest, like, troll Pokemon ever. So, its ability was Unaware, which is when your opponent's stat gets raised, when you get, like your attacks and their attacks on you... Those stat raises don't matter.
Mm.
Like, it just doesn't take them into account. So, Swagger boosted your opponent's attack and confused them. They hit themselves harder. They did not hit you harder.
Okay.
So, its move pool was Swagger for confusion and hitting themselves harder. Thunder Wave for guaranteed paralysis. Waterfall for a flinch chance. And Super Fang to just cut their HP in half.
Nice. That's cool.
It was the dumbest fucking thing, and it was great.
I'd love to see a competitive battle team where you have, like, Love Disc. That would be fun.
Yeah, Love Disc is shit. It's absolutely shit.
I think Love Disc is in Little Cup.
It's a total support Pokemon.
Yeah.
Because it has, like, no offensive capabilities whatsoever.
Okay.
It confuses, and it makes rain, and it gets the fuck out of there.
Mm-hmm. And a baton passes to him.
I have one more thing, and then we can wrap up.
Okay.
Recently, I don't know if I talked about this in the show, but I told you, Lennon, about Grump Aesthetics, which is a Tumblr that's all about really ridiculous quotes from Game Grumps.
Oh, okay.
Put in, like, really calming-looking, beautiful backgrounds.
Oh, that's right! Those are amazing!
Those are great.
I recently discovered
another Tumblr called Grump Quote of the Day, which, it's not as much a theme, but it is Game Grumps-based, and it's hysterical most of the time.
I love whenever Aaron Hansen says he has no chin.
Yes.
He's known for having all the chins.
Yep. But it's got a ton of different related stuff to that. There was a... The one that I saw in particular that I'm going to put in the links...
All right.
...was an image from that show, that Nickelodeon show, iCarly, with Miranda Cosgrove.
Okay.
If you know what that is, people listening...
Not really,
listening,
but I'll... Yeah.
There's a scene where she has her hair different, and it makes her look exactly like Aaron Hansen, and it's a little bit terrifying. Here, I'll show it to you right now, and okay. Then I'll put in the link so you people at home can see it.
And the quote alongside?
The, what?
Isn't there, like, a quote alongside it, or it is
says,
it just that picture?
It says something like, it says, look at me in the eyes and tell me this doesn't look like, just like Ego Raptor.
Oh, okay. It's all right. It's up there.
I thought it was funny. But there's a lot of stuff.
Hey, I'm drunk.
Like, Aaron...
It's not quite there.
Aaron playing any Mario game, it's a vine in which it's... They're playing Super Mario Galaxy, and he's like, watch this. I bet I can... I'm gonna clear this jump. And he just whacks on the side and flies down. He's like, no, I can't.
That's every Mario game he plays ever.
Yep, pretty much.
Yeah.
Okay.
He sucks things.
Rolls' brow is furrowing, so...
He's thinking about when are you guys going to get over Game Grumps?
I'm slowly on my way out.
Like,
I'm
is thinking it about a it. Realistic question?
I'm thinking about it. I'm sick of their Mario and Zelda stuff. That's all they've been doing for a while. They finished
just
one Zelda
sick
game,
of,
they moved
I'm
to the
just
next
sick
one,
of, like... Okay, this one guy's opinion is going to influence everybody's opinion on games in general?
I don't think that
that's kind of what pissing me off about the Sonic community.
I don't think it happens, though.
I think it does.
I think it happens a little bit.
Really?
Yeah, I think...
I think you've talked a lot more shit about Sonic
well,
since
sucks.
Watching him.
I've always thought it sucks.
Yeah, always. But you brought it up a lot more.
Well, it was relevant-ish. With new games coming out and... Sonic, I don't pay attention to Sonic.
Sonic movie.
They put Sonic... Watching it on Game Grumps... Put Sonic in my brain a little more.
Yeah. I'm about to stop watching Mark, too, to be quite honest.
Really?
Yeah.
I haven't watched Soma very interesting.
I haven't watched him that much lately.
I'm liking Soma so
I've been talked into watching Jacksepticeye, and he doesn't suck.
Yeah. He's in my new video.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he is.
I've caught a lot of channels out recently, actually. Like Game Theory and a few other... Game Theory. I've been watching Hellfire Comms recently, and they pretty much joke
Hellfire Comms always comments on how much Aaron sucks at games on Game Grumps.
Yeah, but
every single video.
That's funny.
I love that. I love that they also talk shit of Game Theories too.
Oh yeah,
because I was watching their Windwaker.
A game.
Yeah, they said I'm just gonna make a fucking YouTube channel and say the craziest bullshit that might not be fucking in any way tangentially related to the game and say it's a theory. Like,
let's diagnose the angry video game nerd. Yeah.
He's. Leave PewDiePie alone. God, you're defending... That's why I actually lost interest in the channel. You're defending PewDiePie.
He's
I fucking
fine.
Hate PewDiePie.
He's fine.
I don't watch him.
I
don't like him.
Yeah, remember that
he's
one...
Fine.
Remember that one time that we went to the draft, and that one guy was like, yeah, I watch Game Grumps sometimes, but I really like PewDiePie. And we both kind of like...
Fucking plebeian. But, Nah, I was... Mark is... I like Markiplier. I really do.
Of course,
do.
Yeah.
But...
He just hit 10 million. Like,
he's going a little more kooky and zany than he used to. I mean...
I almost feel like that comes with the territory.
A little bit.
But it doesn't. You right? can be smart and reserved. See, I'm like... That's my whole thing that I had against Grumps, too, when you guys first got into it. It's like, I like the smart and intelligent and reserve commentator.
I'm going to bring up Jacksepticeye again, because the way I was persuaded into watching him...
Let's yell and make random noises?
Same people who were coming to my Halloween party who told me, like, you should watch this guy.
Okay.
They said that he does voice acting, and it's actually good.
Oh, really?
And also... he is far superior as far as gameplay goes in every way to Mark.
Okay.
So it's more like, whenever...
I don't think people watch for gameplay.
Yeah.
If they did, things like Demo Disc wouldn't exist.
I know, but in this particular niche of Let's Playing, sometimes you just want to be like, Okay, go. Just let's see what that the next part is.
You could just go.
You could just go.
Yeah. No, I'm a kleptomaniac. I have to collect every ring. Could just go, Lewis.
I take every opportunity I can to say that.
Yeah. You could just go. You could. That was my phone. You could just go.
Your phone went. You're slamming shit. This is over now.
This is over now.
No, let me finish the thing about Mark real quick.
Okay.
Okay.
Make it 5 minutes long so we hit 2 hours.
Gotcha.
No, I'll fucking punch you.
Okay.
You won't know, but I will.
That's really not a threat, honestly. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's, you know, he's got the pink hair, and I was like,
meh. He did that for charity. That was
yeah, I understand. That's, yeah. I understood. I learned that, and I understood that.
Yeah.
But, you know, and then, oh, here. I think it's... Now, tell me if this is a business sense or not.
Okay.
I think it's... Since he was featured on Kimmel...
Okay.
To bring it back to what we talked about the last time we were all here.
Yeah.
I think he's been playing the character more than playing Mark.
Nah. I agree a little bit.
Really?
I do.
Huh.
Not that his character's bad.
He's very genuine, but I think he's playing it up a little bit.
Hmm.
Because maybe like, not publicly.
He needs to catch the viewer that saw that and be like, oh, maybe check this out, you know?
Well, okay.
I'm sure he's as genuine as Mark Sanchez can get. Yeah. But I think that he has to feel like he has to keep up that persona. Even if it
means
going off the beaten path a little bit.
Yeah, I agree with that, you're right.
And that and like the meow video.
That was funny.
It was funny. Oh my God. It was really funny, but at the same time, I was like, "What the fuck is this?"
I love his story that he told on.
Then he'll win me back with a great, like a great LP or a great animated.
Yeah.
When he told a story,
is it my birthday?
Did he like? Was he like? Hey guys, it's me again. I just wanted to tell you that I really appreciate all the support
you've
been giving me. I just have this one story I want to talk about.
Yeah. It was a story of him making that.
And I just have to remind you guys that I really do appreciate. I really do appreciate everything you guys have done for me. I would not be here if not for you.
I get you appreciate.
But see, the thing is, I feel so blessed sometimes.
But understanding
that all of you are behind me.
But what does it all mean, really?
Say goodnight, everybody.
No, I wouldn't.
Say fucking goodnight, everybody.
You want 2 hours or don't you?
I don't care anymore. Say goodnight,
everybody. No, 2 hours!
Nah, if I can cut it. Ready? Here we go. Goodnight, everybody.
Wait, I didn't talk about the Democratic debate yet!